Hello, good morning. Welcome to today's lecture on CMOS fabrication process. The CMOS can be fabricated using different process such as N-well process for CMOS fabrication, P-well process, twin-top CMOS fabrication process. The fabrication of CMOS can be done by following the 20 steps by which CMOS can be obtained by integrating both NMOS and PMOS transistors on the same substrate. For integrating these NMOS PMOS device on the same chip, special regions called as wells or tubs are required in which semiconductor type and substrate type are opposite to each other. A P-well has to be created on a N substrate or N-well has to be created on P-substrate. In this lecture, the fabrication of CMOS described using the P-substrate in which the NMOS transistor is fabricated on a P-type substrate and the PMOS transistor is fabricated in N-well substrate. The fabrication process involves 20 steps. The primary start the process with P-substrate. As you know, the best semiconductor material used for fabrication of MOS integration circuit is silicon. Silicon is the material, is a material which is available in abundance in nature and it is very cheap. So there is no dearth of raw material in the nature. You get plentiful, silicon in the form of silicon dioxide or sand. However, you have to use a very purified form of silicon for the fabrication of VLSI circuits. So usually by reactive silicon dioxide sand with carbon, silicon is purified to great extent, then it is used for purpose of fabrication of VLSI circuit. This is a substrate, a purified form of silicon for fabrication of VLSI circuit. This is a substrate and this is the pure form of the wafer. You can see. Step 2, oxidation. The oxidation process is done by using high purity oxygen and hydrogen which are exposed in an oxidation furnace approximately at 1000 degree centigrade. Oxidation can be done by heating this wafer, the substrate, in a chamber like this one heating chamber. This one, and then by passing either oxygen or water vapor. So whenever you passing oxygen, then it is called dry oxidation. And then thin form of silicon dioxide is created on the other hand. Whenever you will be passing, seeing the water vapor, then thick form of silicon dioxide will be deposited. But it is quietly will not be very good. It will be little porous type and it is called thick oxide silicon dioxide. Step 3, the photoresist process. A light sensitive polymer gets softens whenever exposed to light is called as photoresist layer. It is formed like this. This is a photoresist, or it is softened whenever exposed to light. Step 4, masking. The photoresist is exposed to ultraviolet rays through the N-well mask. The photolithographic process, that means you deposit, photographic emulsion photoresist on the top of the silicon dioxide. And then it is spread uniformly for spinning it at little high speed, then you expose it to light with help of mask. This is the mask, here is the penetration, here is not the penetration for the ultraviolet rays. Step 5, photoresist removal. How we can remove photoresist? A part of the photoresist layer is removed by treating the wafer with बेसिक और एसिडिक सॉल्यूशन। स्टेप सिक्स, रिमूवल ऑफ सिलिकॉन ऑक्साइड यूजिंग एसिडिक एचिंग। द सिलिकॉन ऑक्साइड ऑक्सीडेशन लेयर इज रिमूव थ्रू द ओपन एरिया मेड बाय द रिमूवल ऑफ फोटोरेसिस्ट यूजिंग हाइड्रोफ्लोरिक एसिड। स्टेप सेवन, रिमूवल ऑफ फोटोरेसिस्ट। द एंटायर फोटोरेसिस्ट लेयर इज स्ट्रिप्ड ऑफ एज शोन इन द फिगर, टोटली स्ट्रिप्ड ऑफ, यू कैन सी। नेक्स्ट, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द एनवेल। बाय यूजिंग आयन इम्प्लांटेशन और डिफ्यूजन प्रोसेस एनवेल इज फॉर्म। आयन इम्प्लांटेशन इज अ लो टेम्परेचर प्रोसेस बाय विच आयन्स ऑफ वन एलिमेंट आर एक्सेलरेटेड इनटू अ सॉलिड टारगेट, thereby changing the physical, chemical, electrical properties of the target. So we can utilize the arsenic here, arsenic gas here, to create the anvil. Removal of silicon oxide using the hydrochloric acid and remaining silicon oxide is removed. Deposition of polysilicon. Chemical vapor deposition process is used to deposit a very thin layer of gate oxide. This is, you can see, this is the thin gate oxide layer. Removing the next step, removing the layer bearing a small area for the gates, except two small regions required for forming the gates of NMOS and PMOS, the remaining layer is stripped off. Oxidation process, next one. An oxidation layer is formed on this layer with two small regions for the formation of the gate terminals of NMOS and PMOS. Oxidation refers to the conversion of the silicon wafer to silicon oxide, or more generally SiOx. Ability of Si to form oxide layer is a very important, since it is a one of the reasons for choosing silicon over silicon material over germanium. In the case of grown oxide layer, there are two main growth mechanisms: dry oxidation, silicon reacts with oxygen to form silicon dioxide; wet oxidations react with water or steam to form silicon dioxide or silicon oxide. Hence, the thickness of the oxide layer is larger than the thickness of the silicon that is consumed to form that oxide. To grow 100 nanometer of oxide, 53.2 nanometer of silicon needs to be consumed. Masking and diffusion. By using the masking process, small gaps are made for the purpose of end diffusion. N-type dopants are diffused or ion implanted, and 3N plus are formed for the formation of terminals of NMOS. Diffusion is driven by gradient in concentration. As you know, there is a ions gradient. Oxide stripping, next process. Similar to above end diffusion process, the P diffusion regions are diffused to form the terminal of the PMOS. Thick field oxide, that one is the next process. A thick field oxide is formed in all regions except the terminal of PMOS and NMOS. Next one's metallization. Aluminium is spread on the whole wafer. Removal of excess metals, that one also a next process. The excess metal is removed from the wafer layer. Now step 19, terminals. The terminals of PMOS and NMOS are made from respective gaps. Assigning the names of the terminals of the NMOS and PMOS. Terminals of NMOS and PMOS, you can see, this is the body terminal, this is the source terminal, this is the gate terminal, this is the drain for in case of NMOS. PMOS here, this is the source, this is the gate terminal, this is the drain terminal, this is the body terminal. Source and drain terminals are P plus, and body terminals are N plus here. And this is the P substrate and N well, and in N well, we created ion implantations by using trivalent impurities. Here again, and here is pentavalent impurities for creating NMOS like arsenic. Thank you very much. I hope you will continue my next class. I believe that you have got a better understanding of this concept. Furthermore, any queries regarding this concept, please give your valuable suggestions by commenting in the WhatsApp group. Thank you very much.